So now we gotta find Cairns. Man, this place looks shitty. Really grimy. I like it, don't get me wrong, but... yeah. So this guy does a lot of arm wrestling. Oh. Here we are.
Hello there. Are you Cairns?
What do you want?
We've heard all about the gambling on arm wrestling here. You seem like the likely sort, and I'm up for it.
I start at 10 shillings.
Suits me.
Okay, so I'm arm wrestling now. Oh, so follow his facial expressions to understand his moves, push, restrain, idle. In playing your counter strategy, pay attention to something. Oh.
For you, I reckon. You're stronger than you look. Here's your 10 shillings.
I'd like to buy you a drink.
Good winner as well. That's good. Let's have a drink. You're a good type. Seems you've managed to settle down in life. You've got money, eh?
Not all that much.
Oh, well. At least you're not as poor as me.
All right, well, why are you so poor?
Why do you say poor? You're not working.
I'm a harpooner, but you see, the whalers are rare. They don't pay much. So as a result, I find myself arm wrestling to pay for my drink.
A harpooner? Interesting. You've had a lot of adventures, I bet.
Of course. It's been a dozen years since I sailed. I've seen everything. Old Wallace, damn Black Peter, Great Roger, we sailed to the Cape of Good Hope.
Black Peter, you say? I've heard rumors about that one.
He was the worst of them all. He was a liar and violent too. Swinging those fists of his around. He was a tyrant and not much of a captain. At least, not as good as Great Roger.
I see. Yes. I was told terrible tales about Black Peter.
But you ain't heard the worst.
Is that so?
Tell me, and let's have another drink.
It was in 1883 that it happened. The August of that year. Peter Carey was captain of the Sea Unicorn. And I was a spare harpooner. We were coming out of the ice pack on our way home. One evening, we saw a little craft that had been blown north. There was only one man on her, and he wasn't a sailor. The crew must have thought that she'd foundered, and they made for the Norwegian coast in the dinghy. I guess they all drowned. We took the man on board.
And who was he?
I don't know. During the crossing, he and the skipper enjoyed some long talks. His baggage was just a tin box.
That's strange enough.
Aye, even stranger was that on the second night, he disappeared. Nobody knew what happened to him. And of course, nobody could ask Black Peter about it.
You know what happened, don't you?
I do. I saw the skipper tie his heels and push him over the rail in the middle of my watch on that dark night. 2 days before we sighted the Shetland lights.
Black Peter's a murderer.
Aye. And those that know him wouldn't be surprised to hear it. But all this must stay between us. All right?
Of course.
You go around telling strangers shit like that?
Back in a second. I'm off to the Kazi.
I'll be here with my drink.
That's pretty stupid. But hey, you know, good for you. Okay, so Patrick Cairns is an experienced harpooner currently facing unemployment and poverty. He can be found most often in the Sea Witch, a public house deemed popular by the sailors whom he arm wrestles for money. Like many of his kind, he is a heavy smoker, indicated by his yellow fingernails. What else do we have? So there's a concealed murder. Peter Carey was trying to conceal the murder of John Elegant's father. Ooh. Right. Okay. Gotcha. All right, so Patrick Cairns told the story of how in August 1883, he had observed Peter Carey throwing a man overboard. The man had been saved from the sea only the previous night. The man was obviously Joshua Nelligan. Well, I feel like an asshole because I didn't pick up on that initially. Cairns is a smoker. This guy really seems like our guy. All right, John Nelligan doesn't know that his father was murdered by this guy, I don't think. Okay, so I gotta plant the pouch in Peter's pocket. How do I do that? Ah, here we go.
Here it is. Have you got any tobacco? We've run out of mine.
Nah, I lost my pouch. I don't know where. Wait a minute. What's this?
Oh, is this your tobacco pouch?
Well, oh, it is.
Ha.
Well, I have to go now. I know a captain who's planning an expedition to Cape Cod. Captain Ahab's his name. He commanded the Pequod. He might need good harpooners. I'll tell him about you.
Maybe, if you like, aye.
I'm done here. It's time to leave.
And let's try to make some deductions here. Okay, so Patrick Cairns' pouch. Maybe? Yeah, okay, there we go. Pouch proves guilt. Cairns has confirmed that the pouch belongs to him. This means that he was at the scene of the murder and thus proves his guilt. Cairns has confirmed that the pouch belongs to him. This means that he was at the scene of the murder but does not necessarily prove that he is the murderer. We don't really have any evidence to really condemn any of these people yet, so I'm gonna go with that. Okay. I want to say the person that I think is the most likely to have done it is Cairn, but I don't want to...
You met really... Patrick Cairns, the harpooner. Do you believe he's the murderer?
I don't really want to rely on that quite yet, though. I doubt it. Really? Those two go together? Alright. Okay, so it has been confirmed that Liam Hurtley was flirting with Peter Carey's wife and even fell in love, but it didn't go beyond the affectionate but harmless letters and words. Liam Hurtley loved Judith Carey so desperately that he jealously could have provoked him into committing murder. That's tough. Fuck, man. I'm not sure. I'm not gonna draw a conclusion yet. Fuck you. I don't need to. I probably do, actually, but I don't wanna. I really just don't buy... what's his name? Fucking... I can't remember. What was it? I don't buy that Hurtley did it. I really just don't. I'm really actually starting to go back to Nelligan on this. I mean, I don't know for a fact that he knows his father was murdered by Carey, but... I gotta say, man, that really is looking interesting. I'm gonna go with harmless flirting on this. Okay, Liam Hurtley's relationship with Judith Carey gives him a motive for killing Peter Carey, or Hurtley's presence at Whitman's Lee on the night of the murder is explained by the affection toward Judith Carey and the fact that he worked there as a gardener. I think that Hurtley's innocent. I really do, and I'm starting to believe that it may have been actually Nelligan. But I don't think that's the motive. I want to find the real motive. So I'm going to go back to the police station in Scotland Yard, and I'm going to see if I can talk to Nelligan about this, because I honestly, like, Cairn could be it. He could be. But I really think that we need to pry and see if Nelligan knows anything of his father being murdered by Carrie. Because that's really important. If he knows that, then I absolutely believe he was the one who did it. What else is there? Okay, so what? Why does it keep coming up? By the way, why isn't that a new bit of information that we can go off of? The fact that Nelligan's father was murdered by Carrie. You would think that would be not evidence, but like something you could, you know, use your deduction skills for.
Please escort this suspect for interrogation.
Tell me there's something.
Tell me, Mr. Nelligan, what exactly were you hoping to find inside Peter Carey's cabin?
I was trying to find some information about my father.
Okay. This probably would be further down. I'm not sure. The bond certificate?
I assume you had another purpose, to retrieve the bond certificates. Am I correct?
Yes. I discovered some time ago that a few of the missing securities had reappeared on the London market. You can imagine my amazement. I spent months trying to find them, and at last I discovered that the original seller had been Captain Peter Carey. These papers, they belong to my family, but I could not find them there.
That's all for now. Well, I will see you soon, young man.
Now I'm really perplexed, because I suppose, alright, I guess he doesn't know. So do I need to draw my conclusion now? Okay, so the more and more I'm considering this, you know, clearly the digging I've done has shown that Nelligan is not aware that his father was killed, and even though I really want to say that he would be guilty because that's the strongest motive out of any of them, he just doesn't fit the part. He just doesn't, the way he's acting doesn't fit it to me. So to go with that, he doesn't have the feat of strength that Cairns does, and that really tells me something. So I'm actually going to go for looking for papers here. Yeah, okay. I'm going to go with pouch proves guilt. I think, okay, solve the case by accusing those who are guilty and seal their fate, but be aware there's always more than one conclusion of that case. I'm going to go with Cairns is guilty. So now I have to make this is like a moral decision, from what I recall reading about the game. They have these. So Peter Carey was murdered by Patrick Cairns. Cairns is a professional harpooner. His tobacco pouch was found inside Carey's cabin. So you can either condemn him. The description reads, he's a cold-blooded murderer. He has been found guilty of the murder of Peter Carey and must be punished, or absolve him. He killed Peter Carey, but the murder was not premeditated. It was in self-defense against an armed and irrational drunken sailor. That's a tough one. You know, like, I don't believe that he was going out of his way to kill Peter Carey. But it's really... Shit. I don't think he's cold-blooded, because he looked at Carrie is a piece of shit for doing what he did. So it's kind of like, clearly he has a moral compass of some sort. So I'm going to go ahead and absolve him.
Good afternoon. I must be at the wrong address. I'd like to speak with the ship's captain, a Captain Ahab. Is that you?
No. My name is Sherlock Holmes.
That detective fella? So, you wanted to see me?
That is correct. We need to talk.
About what?
About Black Peter, who was killed in his own hut with a harpoon.
You know, don't ya?
Yes.
How?
The tobacco pouch. You recognized it.
Oh, the sailor. It was you. Unbelievable. Well, fine. I confess. But if you really do know everything, you should also know that I didn't want to kill him. He made me do it.
I know. Did you know about this story with the bond certificates? Did you need money?
Yeah. I just wanted him to cough up a little silver. I'm out of work, and I thought maybe he could help me. Well, he refused outright, and he insulted me. I reminded him I knew all about that murder he committed at sea in 1883. Then he got mad when I spoke about his treasure. I barely just had time to throw the harpoon at him before he could jump at me with his knife. You know the truth. What will you do now?
I ask that you return the bond certificates. Keep some of them. You will need them in your exile. It is better that you leave the country for a few years.
And you won't say anything to the police?
I will not say anything as long as you return the money.
Well, I'll do as you ask. But what about Inspector Lestrade?
I will deal with him. Goodbye.
It's good that you asked me to come, Mr. Holmes. We do need to talk.
About what?
What do you mean? Our case, Mr. Holmes. You sent me a message via your little thug.
His name is Wiggins, Inspector.
Telling me that the case is solved. Well, Mr. Holmes, tell me, who is our murderer and where is he?
The morgue.
Eh?
His name is, or rather was, Pablo Coventrao. He was also on the ship with Peter Carey, and he was a harpooner. I'll tell you everything, Inspector, but do calm down. Mrs. Hudson will bring us tea and orange cake.
Orange cake? You're spoiling me, Mr. Holmes. That's my favourite.
Ah, Mr. Holmes. Inspector Lestrade told me that I should thank you for clearing my name. He also said that you were waiting for me here. I came as fast as I could. I cannot thank you enough. It is all because of you that this nightmare is finally over.
I believe that this belongs to you.
My father's securities. Incredible! But how did you get them?
It would take far too long to explain.
Tell me, this is extraordinary. You are a genius.
Then that may serve as an explanation. Goodbye, Mr. Nelligan, and good luck.
Goodbye, Mr. Holmes, and thank you. 1,000 times thank you.
I'm kind of annoyed. Alright, well, let's go ahead and read this first. Okay, Peter Carey was murdered by Patrick Cairns, professional harpooner, the only one capable of executing such an accurate throw. His tobacco pouch was found inside Carey's cabin, but the murder was in self-defense against an armed and furious drunken sailor. You have decided to absolve Patrick Cairns. Okay, well, look. Here's something that I have a little bit of an issue with before I check and see if my conclusion was correct. I'm pretty sure it is, given the way he was acting. But I felt like it made me make a decision on how to go about everything before I had all the information. Unless I missed something huge, the part where it says absolving Cairns, and it says like he was acting in self-defense, I felt like that information was unfounded. I don't recall ever coming across anything regarding that, and it was almost as if it was just an assumption. I chose it because I was under the impression that was genuinely what was happening. And yes, he did defend himself, but it was under a different context than what I thought. I was thinking that, Carey was, out of his mind and he was psychotic. And yeah, he was being an asshole, but he was, you know, being blackmailed. You know, he was upset. He was angry. I'm not saying it makes it okay for what he did, but it does change the story a little bit. And it makes it to where it's like, okay, no, Cairns, you were being a fucking dick. All right. And yeah, you should go to prison for that. You killed someone. And you provoked them. You provoked them to attack you, and then you killed them. So, I wish that I could go back. I could go back and condemn him, but that would be stupid, and yeah, it's pointless. But I really, that kind of bugs me, and I hope that that's not something that continues. But, yeah, overall, I still enjoy doing the case. It's just that last bit kind of bugs me a little bit. So, let's find out if I got it right. And I did! Cairns is guilty. Shocker. Alright, well, let's accept our decision. Well, hold on. Warning, you're about to finish the case. The save files for this case will be removed, blah, blah, blah. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and stop the video here. So if you enjoyed the video, please be sure to like and subscribe and all that. And I will see you guys next time. Suck your dick.
What is this going on?
I challenge you to a watermelon eating contest.